This is the biggest, most expensive Beals Science build of all time. Hey guys, welcome to Beals Science. I'm Craig Beals with a 1979 Postal Delivery Jeep with a bowling ball cannon.
Yes.
Mounted in the back. This was never supposed to happen. So we went down to the scrap yard, started looking for steel tubes, found a tube. And by the time we left the scrap yard, not only did we have a tube, we had the shell of a Jeep. It didn't look like this. It was literally just a shell. And so over the course of the next 2 months, I set Sean free on this build and he went totally crazy. Under the hood, look at this. It didn't run, it didn't have anything. And look at it now. We got Jeep update. Look at this bad boy! It runs! It purrs like a kitten. Now mind you, it did not have a carburetor. It did not have a radiator. It didn't have any of the belts. It didn't have distributor. It didn't have battery. It didn't have starter. It didn't have brake solenoid. It had nothing. Now it does. Now we've got this Jeep on our hands with a cannon in the back. And really all I got left is to drive it around a little bit, see if we can tear it up, and then shoot this cannon off. We're towing the Jeep out into the flatlands of Montana, and we're gonna shoot this thing and see how far they go. But we got about an hour drive to get there, and that probably gives us a good amount of time to really think about our feelings and think about our decisions, and whether or not this is really that great of a decision at all. But either way, we're gonna make this cannon go boom. Put on the safety glasses. Oh, somebody's gonna get hurt here today.
Oh man.
A good place to be during a thunderstorm. I was worried about the cannon. Maybe I should be worried about Mother Nature. My wife made me promise not to kill the kids. I'll try my hardest. We're strictly going off of, I mean, we don't know. There's no handbook, it turns out. This is the powder. We got 10 pounds of powder. I don't think we should probably do it all at once. I think we're gonna start with about half. Anybody wanna vote? Half a pound? What you got in your ears there?
Protection.
Let's go. I'm gonna turn all these on.
Full send.
Because we're changing YouTube. We're making the world a better place through the YouTube. We're educating America through bowling balls and gunpowder and cannons. We've got approximately 15 different cameras. I think the only reason people showed up to film this is because they think it's gonna blow up. There we go, we're filled up with powder. We got half a pound powder. We don't know if that's enough or if it's too much. This is like a bottomless pit.
Yeah.
I don't think I should have my face this close. I chose this one because Brenda, whoever Brenda is, had a really nice ball with metallic in it. Okay, here we go. Okay. There you go, we're live. That wasn't bad, right? I think it was. We need more powder.
More powder.
We need more powder. That was awesome!
Do it again.
We'll load it up. Half a pound was not enough. When in doubt, go bigger. Like we say in my chemistry class, if a little good, more is better. And then I remind the students that's not really true in chemistry class. It's a large grain black powder that the goal is to have it burn really slowly to build up pressure behind it instead of just have one big kaboom. This, when it turns into a gas, takes up more space than it does when it's a solid. As it expands, takes up space inside of there, it's got to push that ball out. And I think that a lot of it escaped around the outside of the ball on that other one. I can't imagine this is normal protocol, where you just put the whole package in there.
Whoa, hey, we're back.
So this proves the theory
that
if a little is good, more is better. Well, plus we changed the angle. I mean, that thing just hung out there for
long time.
Approximately 45 minutes. All right, we got one more angle.
Yeah, let's do it.
We have destroyed all sorts of things. We have bowling balls scattered across the landscape, but we're going big with a pound and a half of powder. So the most we've gone so far is a pound of powder. And we're gonna crank it up to about 35 degrees. We can only launch so many bowling balls a long distance before we get bored of launching bowling balls a long distance. So, we're gonna shoot this toilet with a 10-pound bowling ball and watch it explode. I think we may connect. And if we do, we're gonna wash our hands and we're gonna leave this hilltop forever, because you know what? We have achieved ninja status of bowling ball cannoning.
Hey, he's fucking. Whoa.
This has without a doubt been one of my favorite builds of all time. Look at this thing. It's a Jeep with a cannon in it. It's awesome. What I'd like to do is hear from you. What do you think we should shoot out of this thing? What do you think we should shoot at? What should we blow up? I mean, give me some ideas. Put them down there in the comments. That'd be fantastic. Maybe hit the little like button. Ooh, thumbs up. Even better, hit the subscribe button over there. I got a lot more videos coming up. Plus, you're gonna wanna see what we do next with this bad boy. And if you want more, come over to BealsScience.com. I need to give a lot of people thank yous. First of all, I need to give Sean Jones, who helped create this masterpiece or disaster, whichever way you look at it. And of course, thank you to Grizzly Creek Films, who showed up here because they wanted to see this thing go boom, and they brought the big cameras, and you know, things just wouldn't have been the same without their amazing cameras. And of course, Houston Harmon, who brought us out to his ranch in the center of Montana and just let us launch bowling balls. I mean, you know, that's pretty sweet. And countless other people who have helped out on this project the whole way through. I thank you for watching, I really do. And like we always say at the end of every little Beals Science video, keep on learning.